I am starting with some white and a thin round brush. This is a number 2. I believe it's a Low Cornell. And I'm just going to sketch out a champagne glass. I'm doing it pretty dramatically diagonally on my forehead because I want this glass to be pouring out our champagne, which is going to be chunky glitter. So just go ahead and sketch it out. I started pretty light at first, and then I went ahead and darkened it up a little bit. And now I'm taking a light blue and filling in the stem and just giving a blue highlight on the inside of our glass so that it stands out a little bit. And then I'm going to do a little bit of a white highlight as well so that it looks kind of like glass. Now I'm going to take my favorite star stencil. It's a hot wing stencil, and I actually cut off part of the wing because it annoyed me, but I love these little stars and I love the shape of them. So just white paint on a dauber, and I'm going to lay those stars over my eye and then going down my cheek. And they're just the cutest, tiniest little stars. They're perfect. Love this stencil. So there we go. And then I'm going to use the other part of the stencil that has that cool swirly starburst on it. And I'm going to do that next to my champagne glass on my forehead. Design is really easy. It's really, after you draw the champagne glass, it's chunky glitter and stencils. And then I dipped right into my Mama Clown glitter that I love. It is amazing, sparkly awesomeness. And I'm going right over my stencil so that my design on top is super glittery. Okay, and I'm just using petroleum jelly here. I'm going to lay some down on the inside of the champagne glass and then pouring out of the champagne glass and around my eye so I can get our chunky glitter on there. If this is something you're going to do on a client or if you're going out, you're definitely going to want to use glitter glue, but for my sake, the petroleum jelly worked just fine. And I am using Multimix by the Gypsy Shrine, which the Gypsy Shrine, if you have not checked them out, they have the most amazing chunky glitter. I'm obsessed with it. I have purchased too much, but I love it. And the Multimix is really, really cool. You can see it has these huge chunks of glitter, but then it also has tiny little stars and little circles. And I really, really like it. I've used it a few times. I think I've used it on another video too. It's falling all over me, but that's okay. You just pick up the bigger chunks with your Q-tip and put them right where you want them. And the other thing about this chunky glitter that I like is that it's very manipulable and malleable. So I didn't like that huge chunk in the glass, so I just kind of grabbed it with my fingernail and I put it down where I liked it. So one thing you want to do when you're doing this is make sure that there's a little bit of chunky glitter on one side of the glass, and then start the chunky glitter pouring out thinner and then get thicker as you get to the middle, kind of the corner of your eye, and then go thin again so that it has a nice flow to it. You don't want it all to be like one depth. It's not going to look as cool. Now I'm also grabbing this awesome holographic silver chunky glitter because I want this to sparkle and I want there to be a mix of textures. The Multimix is really cool, but it's all kind of the same value. Adding the chunky glitter and the silver holographic is just going to take it up a notch and make sure it's all very, very sparkly. So just adding that in where there's any holes and on the outside, you can see I'm just kind of rolling it on. I think this is a really, really fun design. And like I mentioned, really easy. So there's our champagne glass pouring out our chunky glitter. Kind of fun, right? And now I do want to add some of the silver holographic glitter on the other side because I want to balance this design out, of course. If I have one side of my face shining and the other not, it's just a little too much on one side. So if I'm just going to do kind of two stripes of the chunky silver glitter on the top and bottom of my stars. And I do feel like this look looks much better with lipstick, so I am going to throw on one of my favorite red lipsticks just to bring it all together. And this red lipstick I am using is the Melted Matte Lipstick by Too Faced, in case you're wondering. Great lipstick. I have it in a lot of colors. Huge fan. I did decide that the design on the top, the stencil, needed to be extended a little bit, so I carefully lined it back up, and I just extended it out a tiny bit because it just didn't seem balanced. So that's much, much better to me now that it's pushed a little bit further back. And I decided I needed a little bit more glitter on the other side of my design, so I added that. Fixed my hair, and there is my sparkly fun champagne New Year's design. Of course, this is great for New Year's Eve or New Year's Day and any events you might have. You can also put the year right in between the champagne glass and that main star. I just did not do that in this design. I wanted it to be a little bit more universal and last throughout the years, but throwing the date on top would be perfectly great for this. There's space for it. And stay tuned for a tip to remove chunky glitter. So one of the things that I have figured out as someone who paints their face a lot is that I usually have glitter stuck on me and it's really hard to get off. When I use a rag, I tend to just push it all over my face and it doesn't remove it. So I've started using tape. Just grab whatever tape you have, roll it over, and you can see I'm just kind of sliding it. And the chunky glitter sticks right to it. So you can roll it over your fingers and you can slide it or press it, and your glitter comes off much, much easier. So not only is this good for chunky glitter, but it's actually amazing for the fine glitter that we all use as face painters. It removes it so well. I like using it for chunky glitter, but I find sometimes when I have that ultra fine glitter on me, a rag won't take it off. Nothing will take it off. Tape removes it. It's amazing. So you can see I'm just pressing it down, pulling up. And you just kind of try to keep finding a clean spot, because if you go over with the same spots, it won't work. But there you go. Sticks to the tape. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. And I do want to take this time to thank you for a wonderful 2017 with my YouTube family. Thank you to all of my subscribers, everyone who has commented and liked my videos. I appreciate you guys so, 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 so much. Thank you so much for a wonderful 2017. And I look forward to seeing you in 2018 with more videos.